Welcome to the Cybathlon. This is the world's first bionic games.
If you haven't heard of Cybathlon before, you're definitely not in the minority. In short, it's an athletics or Olympics type event in that it only takes place every 4 years, where pilots with disabilities and technology development teams vie to compete in six separate disciplines, which are designed to emulate everyday life tasks. Powered arm prosthesis, brain control interface, powered exoskeleton race, functional stimulation bike race, powered leg, powered wheelchair. With 15% of the world's population living with some form of disability, progress in the assistive technology sector is critical. The spirit of competition has historically been one of the biggest drivers of innovation. But like so many events of 2020, Cybathlon's second iteration came close to not going ahead at all.
Due to the COVID crisis, we unfortunately had a lot of teams that had to give up. They could not train or they could not access their device, and that's really, really a pity. There were 18 teams registered originally, and only seven can compete as of today.
With COVID-19, Cybathlon has seen unprecedented changes. But unlike the Olympics, Cybathlon's technical ingenuity enabled them to press ahead with a new online-only format. Many of the teams rely on Cybathlon to get their projects and progress in front of the eyes of the world, putting them in a better place to secure vital research and development funding for the years ahead. In Cybathlon, the athletes wearing the state-of-the-art technical assistance devices are referred to as pilots. Like in any test pilot program, these people are the best of the best, requiring stamina, discipline, and faith enough in the tech to really put the time in. Silke is the lead pilot on whose shoulders lie TWIICE's prospects at Cybathlon.
We met in 2016 because they were looking for a testing pilot for their exoskeleton. And one team member, Jemina Fazola, called me and asked me if I would like to try. And that was the beginning of the story. I had been a circus performer for many years. I did a national circus school in Germany, in Berlin. And then I worked as a trapeze artist and contortionist until the year 2007, where I had an accident. I fall off the trapeze and I broke my back. And since then, I'm a paraplegic.
She's been willing to train a lot. She's really, really dedicated. We're really, really lucky to have her on the team. She's really driving the team forward with her dedication, and that's really an example for us all. But for her, it's been quite exhausting, these long training sessions and the pain because of the operation has for sure been an obstacle on the human side.
There was some moment, it was like, yes, a bingo moment when my brain became part of the machine, when the machine was part of me and I could use it as if it was my amplified body. And that is a beautiful moment because you don't have to think about each movement and every task and every little thing you have to do. The things become more fluent and automatic. And also when I reach that state, my brain goes into my legs and my brain goes into my whole body, and I have the feeling to use my whole body again, and that's very beautiful for someone who is paraplegic.
With a remarkable improvement in performance and technology since Cybathlon 2016, Silke and the team at TWIICE were able to claim the silver medal in their category. The event will go on to take place in 2024. Silke and the team will no doubt be there, pushing the limits of what we thought previously impossible.